Assalamu alaikum, fratelli e sorelle, rieccoci qua. Spero che tutti voi state bene. Io, alhamdulillah, sto molto bene perché, come vedete, sono in un bellissimo fiume del Regno Unito. Oggi vorrei continuare un argomento che ho preso qualche giorno fa nei miei video precedenti, parlando dei miracoli che sono menzionati sul Corano. Ho parlato dell'embrione menzionato nel Corano, ho parlato del cervello menzionato nel Corano. Oggi parleremo dei mari e dei fiumi. Oggi guarderemo un video che appunto riguarda dove è citato sul Corano, dove è menzionato sul Corano i mari e i fiumi. Appunto sul Corano è menzionato che ci sono due mari che si incontrano ma che non si trasgrediscono, ed è proprio sulla sura Ar-Rahman. E poi anche sulla sura Furqan, appunto, viene menzionato appunto in un versetto appunto questa barriera che fa da separazione. È una barriera che comunque noi con l'occhio umano non possiamo vedere, che solo da pochi anni gli scienziati con apparecchiature specifiche hanno visto questa separazione che va dall'acqua salata all'acqua dolce. Guardiamo insieme.
He has let free the two bodies of flowing water. Meeting together between them is a barrier which doesn't transgress. Quran, chapter 55, verse 19-20. This verse from the Holy Quran illuminates to us that the oceans don't blend with each other despite all storms and enormous waves. Indeed, science affirms the verse of the Quran as it generally has been and demonstrates that it is the word of Allah. According to French marine scientist Captain Jacques Cousteau, who is known for his underwater research, explains the result of his investigation about water barriers as follows. We were exploring some analyst's decision, which said that there were a few boundaries that separated various masses of oceans mixing from one another. Because of different investigations, we saw that the Mediterranean Sea has an exceptional, or rather, different level of salinity and density. And when we checked on the mass of water in the Atlantic Ocean and saw that it was rather completely different than the Mediterranean Sea. However, these two seas, which merged supposedly, should have been equal or at least near to equal in terms of salinity, density and life forms that they had. The scientists then explained an event upon their investigations that they came across, which amazed them. He said that there was a great water curtain or barrier at the merging point of the seas that did not allow these two seas to mix up together. This finding, which Captain Cousteau came up with, was explained in the Holy Quran 1400 years ago. One more sort of water boundary on earth is seen at bays and deltas, where the fresh waterways fall into the oceans. Waterways that have the highest level of probability of mixing into each other due to their surface and base flows never mix up with salty water where they fall into seas. If a barrier hadn't been put up by the Almighty, these freshwater rivers on earth would mix up with the salty seawater and the living creatures in them, and in their environment would be destroyed altogether. In other words, the Quran relates to this miracle of not mixing of these fresh and salty waters, in other words, as follows. It is He who has let free the two bodies of flowing water, one palatable and sweet, and the other salt and bitter. Yet has He made a barrier between them, a partition that is forbidden to be passed. Quran, chapter 25, verse 53. When salt water is mixed with a cup of sugar water, the two will mix very easily when combined as they contain the same solute. However, this verse of the Quran points out that the two bodies of salt water do not mix. Yes, the fact that the seas do not mix up with each other and the freshwater rivers do not mix up with salty water shows the divine power of Allah, which was expressed 1400 years ago in the Quran, proves that the Quran is the word of Allah. Its words are divine and contain very deep and mind-blowing meanings behind each word. May Allah grant us the understanding of the Quranic verses and to act upon it. Ameen.
Consider the following Quranic verse. He has let free the two bodies of flowing water, meeting together. Between them is a barrier which they do not transgress. Al-Quran, chapter 55, verses 19 and 20. In the Arabic text, the word barzakh means a barrier or a partition. This barrier is not a physical partition. The Arabic word maraja literally means they both meet and mix with each other. Early commentators of the Quran were unable to explain the two opposite meanings for the two bodies of water, i.e. they meet and mix, and at the same time, there is a barrier between them. Modern science has discovered that in the places where two different seas meet, there is a barrier between them. This barrier divides the two seas so that each sea has its own temperature, salinity, and density. Oceanologists are now in a better position to explain this verse. There is a slanted unseen water barrier between the two seas through which water from one sea passes to the other. But when the water from one sea enters the other sea, it loses its distinctive characteristic and becomes homogenized with the other water. In a way, this barrier serves as a transitional homogenizing area for the two waters. The scientific phenomenon mentioned in the Quran was also confirmed by Dr. William Hay, who was a well-known marine scientist and professor of geological sciences at the University of Colorado. The Quran mentions this phenomenon also in the following verse. And made a separating bar between the two bodies of flowing water. Al-Quran, chapter 27, verse 61. This phenomenon occurs in several places, including the divider between the Mediterranean and the Atlantic Ocean at Gibraltar. But when the Quran speaks about the divider between fresh and salt water, it mentions the existence of a forbidding partition with the barrier. It is He who has let free the two bodies of flowing water, one palatable and sweet, and the other salty and bitter, yet He has made a barrier between them, and a partition that is forbidden to be passed. Al-Quran, chapter 25, verse 53.
Mashallah, veramente questo video fa vedere proprio la prova che proprio sul Corano descrive assolutamente quello che l'umano ha scoperto dopo tantissimi anni. Questa è la prova che sono le parole di Dio, Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, e che comunque noi dobbiamo assolutamente credere al Corano perché è veramente la parola di Dio, Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. Quindi appunto queste sure, questi versetti descrivono assolutamente questa divisione tra l'acqua salata e l'acqua dolce, e appunto tra queste due acque c'è la zona di separazione che è assolutamente menzionata sul versetto, quindi è veramente scioccante come cosa. E io spero che con questo video avete imparato qualcosa. Se ho sbagliato qualcosa, se avete qualcosa da commentarmi, scrivetemi pure. E a presto allora, assalamu alaikum.